curve. Not flattening it, we're behind the curve. We're all out of shape because we haven't played really for the most part in at least 6 months. But I don't think you're going to notice a difference because I have 25 of the greatest musicians in Central New York on this stage tonight. And then there's me. Boy, you've been practicing at home the last 6 months. All right, so we're going to start the big, and sorry for the late start, but that's, we're getting back in shape, we're getting things, you know, sound checked and organized. Well, we're good to go now. So we're gonna finish off the night with the Abbey Road stuff. So therefore, the last song is The End, and that's the end of the Beatles' recording career. I decided to choose this song because it's the very first song on the very first album the Beatles ever did, the Please Please Me album. And it goes like this. 1, 2, 3, 4!
I'm not afraid to die.
This is the early Beatles section of the show, playing everything before they started taking LSD. Yo, it's the truth. Well, wait, first Dylan said, "Hey man, I thought you said, I get high. But they did that first. Then they did the LSD. Anyway, please put your hands together for the early Beatles segment, folks. This is all the way from, well, the Utica area, but officially Waterville. Mark Burns, a BeatleCuse staple for all 6 years. And then playing Ringo, we call him Dingo. Look at this beautiful drum set from the 60s. It's a Ringo set, the Oyster Pearls from Ludwig. This is Dan Clausen. If you ever want a cup of coffee and you're in the village of Liverpool, stop by Cafe 407. He and his wife operate that along with Ophelia's Place, the nonprofit organization. So every cup of coffee you buy goes to a good cause. You, on the other hand, did the Beatles ever wear a hat like that? Folks, this is a great guy, and he's keeping me and Mark honest. He's sending YouTube videos of, you know, John and George played an A minor, but McCartney played a C on the bass two beats during that song. So, you know, you want to do it right. He may be country, but he's a lot rock and roll. This is Sean Free.
But he's anal retentive.
In this day and age, we didn't, you know, we're trying to save trees. We didn't print out set lists. Oh, okay. The features Sean.
Well, I took some honey from a tree, dressed it up and they called it me. Everybody's trying to eat my baby. Everybody's trying to eat my baby. Everybody's trying to eat my baby. Well, up last night, head fast forward, 50 women knocking out my door.
He has that Vox AC, whatever. had it hotwired by the people at Rickenbacker, so this is cool. He's authentic. We're gonna play a bunch of 12 string songs.
Thank you.
and every one of you for selling this place out today. Now, this is a sellout because of the Cayuga. This is Cayuga County, so thank you very much for selling. I can say that I finally played a sold-out show in my lifetime. And I want to thank you for wearing the mask because that's a very important, very, very important part of this show. That way, the local winery remains open and not bringing any laws. So, you know, I don't want to break any laws either. This isn't going to work, is it? Oh, there. I should have known better than to send the set list to all the musicians and ask them to print them out and not one of them did. I must lubricate the harmonica. No. It's too high for me. Maybe. Because you requested it, Stevie. Anyway, this is a song from Hard Day's Night. One.
Trilogy in the key of E, and we're going to move on to our trilogy in G.
Yeah. No key here, Taco Bell. I want to dedicate this next song to Stevie Shane. Oh, I'm ashamed.
There is more love than I should ever want. She today.
If you haven't seen people in 3 or 4 months, just thank you for being the people we're seeing. Thank you, Linda, for coming all the way from Connecticut for this show. And Peggy over there from the far side of Rochester. Where are y'all from? I mean, other than Syracuse, is there anybody that's traveled?
Mohawk.
Mohawk? Wow, you must be friends of either Lenny or Chris Cooley. Chris, yeah, Lenny, screw him. We joke, we kid, we're 7. I'm gonna hit this high note. Got 2 more songs, and then we're gonna bring on some variety, some acoustics, some harmony, that kind of thing. We hope you will enjoy the show. Because we care. While he's tuning, I want to give a personal thanks to 2 sets of people. One is the owner of this place and the staff, Chris Colloca. I don't know if he's here right now. Keep him around because he actually helped make this happen. He pushed for this to happen. So thank you so much for, so Chris, thank you for building this building just for our event. Hey-o! And the second bunch of people I want to thank are the volunteers who you're going to be seeing come up on stage in between. Whenever anybody, in 2 more songs, we're going to go off stage and there's going to be a whole bunch of new people. So our volunteers are going to come up with Lysol and sanitizer that's donated by Lock One Distilling in Phoenix. And they're going to wipe down every microphone and every mic stand. And maybe, if we're lucky, our own bodies. No, that'd be too much. No, that's not rimshot worthy. But anyway, I want to thank all of them. So when you see people on stage, don't worry. They're here for a purpose. They're going to keep everything sanitized for the musicians. So here we go. Why, Mark? What a high range you have. Thank you for saving me. Early Beatles stuff in a traditional sense. As you can see, we're not wearing boots and suits. Especially you. Well, you're wearing boots. By the way, our time for Sean Freed. He's in Dirt Road Ruckus. So even the country guys know how to rock and roll. Mark Barnes, he's still in a plastic soul band in Utica. It's kind of on hold because of COVID, but still, he is like the ultimate Beatle guy, so please give him a round. And lastly, again, thank you so much for having your Ringo Starr drum set here all day. And again, if you have a cup of coffee in Liverpool, make sure you go to Cafe 407 and support Dan Clausen and his wife, Marielle. Our last song of this set, and then I'm going to bring on some acoustic harmony music. Okay, folks, we're gonna move along here. This is a gentleman who has helped me out the last couple of years of BeatleCuse and Homeward Bound Harmonies up in Alaska. And I want to make sure that we got him to be showcased this year. He's gonna play a couple of solo tunes for us. Ladies and gentlemen, Mark Ballard.
She's standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom.
We're gonna keep that too. That's ringing also. Hold. Okay, we're going to continue on now with some beautiful acoustic music. And one of the good things about BeatleCuse every year is that we twist and turn the songs around and reinterpret them for some fresh ideas and stuff. And at the top of the list are these two fine folks who have an acoustic duo. Well, they're a little more active when it's not COVID-19 the time of year. But this gentleman, he is the editor-in-chief of Acoustic Guitar Magazine. He writes some fine articles in that paper, plus magazine, plus he teaches acoustic fingerpicking and alternate tunings and things. This is going to be very, very interesting. Please put your hands together for Jeffrey Pepper Rogers, winner of the John Lennon Songwriting Contest about 10 years ago. Yoko Ono personally presented the award to him. That's very cool. And his performing partner, who plays a little bit of everything, flute, clarinet, and on a longer night, she'll play accordion and other instruments. This is Wendy Sassafras Ramsey. There you go. So Pepper and Sassafras. Here you go.
Just want to point out that Wendy has her official White Album mask here. Paid big bucks for that thing, you know, to get the official, you'd have it available on the tent.
They should have thought about it. Like a Beatles specific mask.
Thank you. just realizing we did these, we were part of the White Album show right over there. Beautiful day a few years ago. It's lovely to be back. Been a while since we have been on the stage. Suitable for dance. He was a working girl north of England way. Now she's in the big time in the USA. And if she could only believe this is what I'd say. Honey, you are driving me crazy. I'm in love with her lazy. So won't you please come home? Oh, honey, my position is tragic. Come and show me the magic of your Hollywood song. You became the legend of the silver screen.
Call you on the phone and welcome running home. Yeah, that's all I gotta do.
you one more tune
do
here.
Do it again.
Maybe rocking out a bit more on the stage. Thanks to Paul for the opportunity to come and play in this show and had all kinds of cool experiences through BeatleCuse being part of Sgt. Pepper's, playing Indian music and performing as a duo, performing as a band, so very fun.
Also, I gotta say thanks to the sound people. This is like one of the hardest things to do the sound for. And even though I was like shaking, clarinet is like a weird instrument. Person? Oh, it's just you. All right. What's your name? What? Dan? Do you have a name for your company? Do you have a company? Dan the sound guy. Well, thank you. We appreciate it. We know we're sticking.
Last tune of ours, once again, I'm Jeffrey Pepper Rogers, this is Wendy Sassafras Ramsey. We call ourselves as a duo, Pepper and Sassafras. Pleasure to play some music for you today.
When I call, you are
blow off.
Grow, I said grow up.
Chris Cooley, you may know as Chris United.
One year I spelled it wrong is Chris Untied.
Thank you.
I kind of really love him. And also, back here on the drums, another staple of BeatleCuse since year number two. He's been on drums with the Barn Dogs. He's been a percussion specialist for all the album projects. And one mighty fine dude, Pete Szymanski. Meanwhile, on my right, or your other right, on the far side over here, he was in BeatleCuse in October, playing bass for this segment. And what's the name of your Bon Jovi
tribute?
That's the new one that I can't hear about.
Anyway, David Tyler.
I thought it was David Jones.
There he is, Professor Longhair over here, Reese Richida, formerly of the Billionaires, and he sits in still for that sometimes. You can't miss this guy. Excuse me while I kiss this guy. No, you are on fire.
Oh, you
he's one of our two Sammy Hall of Fame musicians from Mr. Monkey, Scott Sterling. Our biggest cheerleaders of this event from the musician side, and with him today is his duo, trio, quattro, thank you, partner, when they were five piece, and Mr. Monkey is going to make a grand entrance, right? Patty Dillman. Ladies and gentlemen, the Mr. Monkey rock and roll segment of the show.
Yeah.
a rock and roll band called Mr. Monkey and an acoustic group called the Acoustic Monkeys. But we're gonna do a little more of this old school rock and roll. Here's one by Chuck Berry that's done by the Beatles.
You do all the things I can't see. Tuna. I have tuna fish too, that's at home. Oh, I wish I could. Yeah, I understand the food is awesome here though. Did everybody eat? Come on! I had a little bit of it. We had some jambalaya. What else did we have?
Was it lobster and macaroni and cheese?
That was good.
It was really good.
The jambalaya was the shrimp and the rice.
She made me eat the shrimp. I love shrimp. And she said, "You're eating this. Eat this now."
Oh, there we go. Patty's gonna rock another number here. Another cover by the Beatles, a Little Richard tune, but Beatles style. Here we go.
Let you give me the brother present.
reason, the music on there, he's watching adult videos, but it's kind of crazy. Don't tell me. We've got a little switch up here.
Little switch.
We're going to bring up.
Do you know this guy?
We're going to bring up the fellow that a lot of people have heard about but never actually seen. This is a BeatleCuse first, my friends. Mr. Paul Davies, creator of BeatleCuse, is going to play the drums for the first time at BeatleCuse. We're going to bring Mr. Pete Szymanski, killing it on drums, up to sing a bit of vocals over here.
Thank you, sir.
If somebody wants to wipe him off, they can.
Thank you, sir. We have seen the law, sir.
Yes, yes. No, I'm not singing. Oh, yes. Here's our last number.
That was.
Thank you very much from the Rock Squad. Thanks for coming out. Thanks to all of our Rock Squad here. Here's one about boys.
Pizza, that was quite scary, actually.
Bye.
two.
Yeah.
Thank you. The sun's gonna go down about 5 minutes.
Good, check. Okay, now we're going to play some soft, intimate music. See if I can remember the words to this.
Uh-huh.
A little bit more of this.
Okay, pretty good.
I gotta play it hard. We're gonna do something that I did with my son Connor back in 2015 when he was still in high school at West Jenny. He was playing trumpet in the West Jenny Field Band. But he went ahead and graduated from college and sold his trumpet, so he doesn't play anymore. So I asked our good friend of the show the last 3 years, who has put together a whole bunch of horn arrangements and general arrangements, one of, if not the best, one of the best horn players of all in the country, let alone Central New York, Jeff Stockham. So, the notorious story goes is that Alan Civil, the best French horn professional in Britain, was pushed to his limits by Paul McCartney, playing notes that were not possible to any human being. So, right, so a couple of pints later at the pub, we got a flugelhorn in Jeff's hands, and so we're gonna do this song, one of my favorites from Revolver. And here we go. Line. Well, hold on, I know the 1, 2, 3, 4 part. Oh, I got it. Oh. Hey, we're all out of shape. Your day breaks. Your mind aches, you find that all the words of kindness linger on when she no longer needs you. She wakes up, she makes up, she takes her time, doesn't feel she has to hurry. She no longer needs you. And in her eyes, you see nothing, no sign. You need her, and yet she don't believe her when she says her love is dead. You think she needs you. This channel. Thank you.
out of, I'm running out of ideas for no opening. Like, I'm using my one of my horses for this party. I had a friend of mine's cat last week looking disgusting.
Yep, I like it.
I want to dedicate today's performance to several people. Check, check. I don't hear anything. Here, check. It's all hot to you. Two. Two.
For like 5 minutes. I know. It's like, geez. Lean forward, Dave.
Two.
Then it's good.
Check. There we go. Thank you. I want to dedicate this show to several people. To folks in the BeatleCuse family who wanted to perform, but are on the conservative side of things, medically, immunity, you know, it's, I respect that wholeheartedly. There are three individuals I want to shout out to, is Bob Halligan Jr., he wished he could be here, and Terry Quill of National Mystery Tour. They're both on the, and Susan Arroyo, a great drummer. She's taking care of her elderly mother, and she just didn't want to take a chance, and I respect that. One person who was prepared to play, but unfortunately his vacation started today, was Todd Holman. So he sends his love and respect, savvy Hall of Famer. But now that it comes to my mind, two more people. I really wanted the Fab Fabs to play today, but Sue couldn't be here. Sharon Allen had to work. Sheila Tucker wishes she could be here. She had to be out of town for a family thing, and we get that. And Kathy LaManna, who was all set to play until she had, finally, the COVID stuff cleared out. She had some hand surgery that needed to, and you're a drummer, the hands are all about it, you know? So, shout out to Kathy. And, two special individuals. Just because, Pete Samansky. You got a gift. He beat cancer. Steve Shad. Yeah. Feature Jeff Stockman again. It's a scaled down version compared to 2017. But it goes something like this. Penny Lane, there is a barber showing photographs. Every head he's had the pleasure to know. All the people that come and go, stop and say hello. On the corner is a banker with a motor car. Thank you. very valuable member of the BeatleCuse family. Reese Richard on piano on that. I see one person printed out the set list. Oh, this is the fun part. We get to bring on a new, a fairly